money, so I ball.
I used to email the venues and ask them if I could be opening an act for the rappers that's passing through town. I used to be the one kids in my city was laughing about. I used to envision everything happening now. I used to ride the bus and listen to Kendrick Lamar. He just liked a video that I made back when I started to study his bars. I'd like to think that he probably related to someone that's come so far. To someone that wanted it badly, then when it got it, it turned to a star. Overly dedicated, a title that resonated. I wanna be recognized, I wanna be decorated. Truthfully, back then I couldn't imagine a life where I never made it. Go ahead and let them hate it.
Let them hate it.
I ain't never had no money. I've been out here trying to give me away. Ain't nobody helping, I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I bought it.
Walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on them. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup. Tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full won't fold on me. How you claim me, you my back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a tutor. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling. Make a living, I'm out here trying to make a killer. Stack a couple million to the ceiling. Then I touch down,
touchdown, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's
them got a red eye, never make right. Me, they are something.
This is playoff football in Chicago. The cold, the wind, the snow, and these Bear fans wouldn't have it any other way here inside historic Soldier Field. Ahead, we'll decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game as we've got a great one in store between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Chicago Bears. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Right out of the gate, we're going to get a delay. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
The delay of game backs him up 5, first and 15. Here's Huntley. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of 6.
I like it. I like it. I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. Running back, and he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. Got what they needed there. The drive continues with a 9-yard pickup. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Here's Ronald Jones, first carry for the USC man. And he'll work this forward for about 3 at 2nd down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Coming up on 2nd and 7. To throw, Huntley. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved. Just as you said, they want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
Gun on 3rd down. Huntley looking for Godwin, but it's intercepted. Picked off near the 42. and they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line. The Bears in good field position to start out first and 10 at their own 42. A first carry now for Kareem Hunt. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. And he'll be brought down right at midfield after a gain of only a couple.
I know the scouting report on him is that he didn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Try to run for the first down with Hunt. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front and linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Now a first down throw complete downfield. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 25 yards that time. Carry here for Hunt, and he'll get 7 yards from the 17 to the 10 before he's taken down. Pretty effective run there, and now they can start to smell that end zone.
Pound the rock. Make sure you use your O-line to set the tone of dominance and physicality, and pound the rock.
On second down, right back to Hunt, and he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. A 5-yard gain there makes it first and goal. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation? We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. Leonard Fournette, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Bears are on the board first here in this division round matchup. Extra point through the snowflakes, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
In on the stop, the former Georgia Bulldog, Roquan Smith. Here's Jones again on second down. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down? They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, three plays, all three short runs, but together a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
Now a handoff as they run left side. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. A gain of three, second down. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second and 7. The give is to Jones. And this is going to be a Bucs first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
Now Jones. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. A big pickup there, 18 yards and a Buccaneer first. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll snag about 5 yards down to the 32.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run? Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. He's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. 45 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
Keep on the ground with Jones. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
On 2nd down, it's Jones. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 4 yards the pickup, 1st down.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up 1st downs.
Now a 1st and 10 at the 11. Off the play fake, Huntley. And he'll go down. Brought down at the 20-yard line. Matthew Ioannidis gets him for a loss of 8. What great push up front. Well behind the sticks here with a 2nd and 18. Off play action. Huntley. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
As defensive coordinators around the league tell me all the time, that throw is not for every quarterback because you've really got to drive the ball downfield. It's going to be a tight window for him to fit that one into. In this case, unsuccessfully.
The Bucs on 3rd down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This will be a tough 3rd and 18. Looking to throw, Huntley. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down.
I like what they tried to do there. Tried to hit him with something quick, get the ball in his hands, and hope he could make some yards after the catch and pick up a 1st down. Weren't able to do so on that play.
The kick by Lutz is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So from an offensive perspective, at least able to get on the board here right in front of the 2-minute warning.
Yeah, now it's time to talk about complimentary football, isn't it? Because if the defense can force a 3-and-out, there could be enough time on the clock that they can get the ball back for the offensive guys and maybe put some more points on the board before the half.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Offense ready to go for their next drive.
And that last touchdown drive they had, very balanced. How key is that balance?
It's huge because most of the time when we talk about balance is run, pass, almost 50-50. But most of the times when you talk to offensive coaches, they say balance is we do what we want when we want to. And that means that they're ahead of the defense, keeping them on their heels.
Yeah, they imposed their will on that last drive. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on 2nd and 12. Fields. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Here's Fields. And this is taken in by Darnell Mooney. And he will have the Bears 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by at Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Field throwing again. He's going to dump this off to his running back, Hunt.
Another miss.
Still on his feet. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 30. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. So first and 10 now from the 30. Now Fields. This one caught. It's the tight end, Hockenson. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. A well-executed 22-yard gain. To throw is Fields. And that is caught. Touchdown, Bears. From 8 yards out, and the Bears will add on to their lead.
Partner, to me, that touchdown had something that was kind of rooted in that group seeing the future. What I mean by that is they have a plan. Let's find a way to score right here before the half, and that'll give us momentum going into the second half, give us that cushion that we're looking for. They got that accomplished, scoring right before the half ended.
McLaughlin for the extra point. This one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. On the return, it's Coates. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And we'll see how they want to play this. Just a little over 20 seconds to go. On first and 10, Huntley. Flush to his right. The ball comes out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. Well, this hasn't been their cleanest first half of football. Last thing they wanted to do was give it up to the opposition, but able to keep it as it goes out of bounds.
Yeah, tough first half, no doubt about it, but if they turn it over there, now things turn a little, how would you say it, dire, and they didn't need that hassle at all. So being able to take care of the football is paramount. Fortunate bounce for them there in order to retain it.
Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. From the gun on third down, Huntley. Airing this one out for Evans. Now he tries to force it in and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 26. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, a trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. at the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And they've been the better of the two teams through two quarters of play, much to the chagrin of this home crowd.
Yeah, this score is a surprise to a lot of folks at home, although not to my dad. He predicted the visitors would win. And maybe to the folks in the stadium, but you know who is not a surprise to, partner? This team with the football. They were very confident coming in.
98 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame as he is trying to will his guys to the championship round next weekend. Hunt. Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the one.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it?
Because he's been patient. Followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
They'll try to run with Hunt. And he's going to be shoved back short of the goal line. They hold him again, and now all of a sudden it's third and goal at the one. This Tampa Bay defense, they held strong on the first two plays. Now third and goal. He'll try to run this one in. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Kareem Hunt punching it in from a yard away. And the Bears continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead. McLaughlin now to add the PAT. And it's 21-3. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. On the return, it's Coates. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Just a couple on the ground there. That's going to bring up third and about six. Jones. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 10 yards there and a Buccaneer first down.
I definitely like the play call. You don't expect it on third and five, third and six, do you? You expect a pass play. Had a little courage there to call the run, and boy, they were successful.
Now a first down carry by Jones. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Second and two. And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 14 yards there and a Buccaneer first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
88 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night. Second down, another shot for Jones.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
They'll
lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down. This is Jones. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. Now they'll toss to Jones running left. And he's taken down after a gain of 3 as they move it from the 22 to the 19. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Back to throw. Huntley. That's going to be caught. And the Buccaneers are going to be set up with a 1st and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the 1. They'll try and run it in with Jones. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Ronald Jones taking it in from a yard out. And the Bucs are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the 3rd. The Bucs offense will stay out there as they'll go for 2.
Let's go deep, tighten up. Let's go deep, tighten up. Check, check. Fresno. Check.
They're going to keep it on the ground. And he's going to get in for the 2 points. And that'll make this a 10-point game. Needed a couple yards for the 2-point try. They go to the ground game, and it works.
And sometimes it's the exact right thing to do because a lot of teams play you for the pass. So you spread people out, decide to run the football. You often find good running lanes.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. This now a 10-point game, so things tightening a little bit after that last score. The run there on 1st down gets him a yard to the 26.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of 1st downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
On 2nd down, right back to Hunt.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
On 3rd down, Fields. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a 1st down. They'll run with Hunt. Finding some room at midfield. Room here to run. And finally taken down at the 34. 130 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 34. And he'll give it here to his running back.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Third down, here's Hunt. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. Just a gain of 2 there, and it's going to bring up a 4th down.
Now, that was a big-time play by the defense. They as well knew where the first down line was, and they didn't let him get anywhere near it.
The offense staying out. They're going to go on 4th and 2. They run for it with Hunt. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. And the drive stays in motion with a nice 8-yard pickup on 4th. The 4th down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on 1st down. On 1st down, they'll run with Hunt. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on 1st down. Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down 4th quarter. Looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys are just saying, let's just keep running it at them. We've got them now.
They got 5 through the air last play, now 5 on the ground. 1st and 10. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is 1st and goal. You got tight. You got tight. You got tight. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the 4th quarter.
Let's go, D. It's going to be a long day like this. It's going to be a long day.
2nd down and goal. Fields. He's got a man. It's his fullback. The catch good for 6 yards, but now it's 3rd and goal.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
A big one coming in this divisional round playoff, 3rd and goal. 3rd down. Hunt. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. Kareem Hunt, his 2nd touchdown of the night. And the Bears are moving closer to a date now in the NFC Championship game as they're able to extend this 4th quarter lead. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. The touchdown. Here's McLaughlin to kick off. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. Their hopes of advancing past this divisional round hanging by a thread, if that, as they begin here with a 1st and 10 on the wrong side of the scoreboard. And his
throw is going to be incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Looking to throw. Huntley. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. Oh, it bowls over it. Second time in this game, Charles, the ball has squirted out from his hands. Luckily, his teammate was there to pounce on it.
You're right. Got the lucky bounce, able to retain possession. You know, we often talk about the combine and why do we measure quarterbacks' hands. Is that really a big deal? It's for situations like this. Do you have the hands big enough and strong enough to hold on to the football while being jostled? That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Eluding the pressure right. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Bears are going to get the football back, and they're going to get it in great field position. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. That time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture, right? Every back that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage, but you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them.
On second down, here's the option. And as he throws, he lost the football. It's loose.
And a little bit of good fortune there. He wasn't able to get it back, but he did have a teammate on the spot able to retain possession for them.
Two minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. Fields now to throw. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. Carlton Davis picks it, and his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. On first down, Huntley. He'll get this one complete to Darden. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First catch for him in these playoffs. He was held without one last week, but he's got a first down on that effort. Huntley's throw into the hands of Darden. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Looking to throw on second down. Huntley, a check down here to Jones. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Back to throw again. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over him, and they got there to break that one up.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete. Well, I kind of got to give him credit. Another incompletion there, yes, but he's still trying to make plays outside the pocket.
Yeah, he's been hemmed in for much of the game. How about him getting outside there? And that's what you want to see from your quarterback. He's not giving up on this game, so every other player in the field has to say to himself, I can't give up either.
Flushed out right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And this is caught. Right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. That goes as a gain of 36 on third down. Not 50, not 50. from the red zone now. They'll look to throw. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And now off to the races down the right side. And they will score a pick six for a Bears touchdown. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And the lead is now 24. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. They knew this would be tough on the road, divisional round, and that has certainly been the case with the deficit they face in this fourth quarter. Throwing after the interception, Huntley dancing to his left. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's really a difficult task.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And now with 6 seconds remaining, they're going to burn their final timeout.
At this stage, there's nothing left to do but to keep firing. And if you're a play caller, you may go off your sheet and use some things maybe you hadn't planned to in this game. Maybe that was one of them there that worked.
Looking downfield for Godwin. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. Both sides, you come into this game with so much hope, so much buildup, looking to move on. One side gets to do that, but let's not forget the other. Tough pill to swallow.
It really is, because it's so much hard work, effort. You mentioned the hope to go on and maybe play in the big game itself. Well, let's see how they handle it, though. The offseason is going to be a long one for them because it's going to eat their heart out watching other people continue to play. But can they come back the next year and find it in them to make that same run again and maybe find a way to advance?
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The Bears get the win at home as we say so long from Soldier Field.
Gotta make the right decision, no, it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see is good intentions, it's the cloud and hit is mad. You can never be a subject, you carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, fuck, I'm trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I played it. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm pacing. I got choices, I'm getting opinions from so many. So I can get up away from all the noise. Too many people tell me what I should do. I take it and laugh. They not knowing if I mess up, I can end up falling flat. If I write a bad tweet, lagging in my whole street. If I give them what they want, then I'm gonna be broke in a week. If I tell my baby no, she might get it from the street. If I'm not tough on my son, he might grow up to be weak. What do I do? I'm new to having cameras in my face. What do I do to keep getting the love from my state? What do I do to keep the money coming in? What do I do? Writing until I need another.
Safety, I'm bleeding. I can never fumble like defense.